Canva recently released 10 new AI-powered design tools and 3 gifts that they had for us. Let's go through some of the highlights and see what they are. Where are you going to find these gifts? Canva has placed them in the middle of your dashboard, and you can scroll through and unleash each one of them. So let's start with Magic Design. What Magic Design does, it helps you not stare at a blank template. To check it out, we're going to click on Try It Out. You click on Insert Image, and then you drop the file that you want to use. And then Magic Design will pick the relevant and the latest design to give you an idea of how you should be designing. So it will help you with the styles, and it will help you with the text and the headline that you could add there. And this is where you drop your image. And when you scroll a little bit down, you can pick one of the templates that you like over there. You can customize it using your brand colors and make it your own. It's just simply amazing. There's no need for you to be staring at a blank screen while you have Magic Design. If you've created presentations before, you're just gonna love Magic Presentations, because when you are ideating and coming up with an idea of a presentation, you usually stare at the blank screen for a long time, thinking of words, thinking of pictures, thinking of where to place animation, etc. With Magic Presentation, all you do, you use 5 or more words to describe the topic that you want to create a presentation for. Say, for example, we would like to present the return on investment on learning and development. Then you would type and describe your presentation and press enter, and then let's see. On your left hand side, you're then given a style option where you can choose what kind of aesthetic you would like for your presentation. And then you can go through the information that has been given. And when you're happy, you can create my presentation. Once the presentation is open, the template's layout is still there, and styles is also added on there under design. So with templates, if you wanted to create a brand new design, you can start describing the presentation over there, and then the AI will generate the presentation for you. Layout have been made a little bit smarter. You can now see suggestions for new ways to arrange your content, and you can just start designing and it'll refresh automatically. The styles section allows you to change the styles and color palette the way that you want. Our next tool is Draw. You can find Draw on the design menu, and it is over there called Draw. It has a pen, a marker, a highlighter, and an eraser, as well as a move tool. And you could choose color that you want as well as the weight that you want. So let's test it out. Let's pick a pen, and you'd write something like that, and you'd go to your color and choose the color that you want, make whatever drawings that you want. And when you want the weight, you could choose the weight by the size over there, or using a plus, and then you could also choose the transparency. If you're on a whiteboard and you choose erase, it erases it like that. If you're on a design and you use your move tool, these become shapes that you could move, and you could do whatever you want. I think this is absolutely amazing. And according to Canva, if you are writing a single stroke and you're trying to draw a circle, for example, this should automatically draw a perfect circle for you. I've tried it a couple of times and it didn't work, so I'm going to show you a clip from the launch, and we'll find out more, and I will share as I find out.
Take a look. Simply select the pen that you want. Customize it with any color or weight to enhance your designs and make your ideas pop. And it doesn't stop there. Elevate your sketches with Shape Assist. Just start by drawing a simple shape, like a star, and Shape Assist will transform it into a lovely polished one.
And if you don't know if you remember, but Magic Write was only available on docs. It's now available on docs, whiteboards, presentation, social media, videos, websites, and so on. So when you are busy designing, so let's jump in on this design, for example. Magic, right, is that assistant that comes with us wherever we're designing. You could find it at the bottom of the page by clicking on the Canva assist, and then the magic, right, is over there. You could then type 5 words to describe whatever it is that you want. And then magic, right, it gave me 5 tips to help with applying makeup on your skin. At the time of recording this video, Magic Right is available in 21 languages. If you've missed this video where I was explaining Magic Right and comparing it to ChatGPT, you can watch it at the end of this video. Next magic tool is Canva Translate. So we're gonna click and activate it and try it out. Once you add it and you try it out, you're going to then find it on your design menu on the side. When you scroll down, it would be added on there. What you could then do, you add text on your page and you type whatever language that you want. It will automatically detect. You can choose from 100 languages. Let's go with Hindi because I have a lot of love from India. And then you select the option where you would like to have the translation to end up to, and you click translate and it's detected. I'm gonna do my home language and I'm gonna pick Zulu and Sawubona. How cool is this? And I've seen a tiny little note from Canva there. It says there are 496 uses left, refreshes at that date. So it looks like we get 500 on Canva Pro. The last thing I want to add on the translate tool is when you click on settings, it automatically defaults to reducing font size to fit, as well as duplicate the page that you're translating. So you can untick this if you don't want the settings and then carry on designing the way that you want. Our next exciting tool, it has been introduced before, it's just been made better. It's text to image. In the past, we only had, I think, 3 or 6 styles, if I could be wrong, but you could go watch this video that I've created of text to images. So we now have 19 different kinds of styles to choose from when you are designing. The other cool thing that Canva has introduced is the sizes that you can choose from. You can choose square, landscape, and portrait. So you could type whatever your imagination brings up to you, choose an image and voila. Add your prompt, scroll down, select the scene that you would like to use, choose your size and create your image. Add it to your design and carry on like that. This is just amazing. Our next cool tools are Magic Edit and Magic Eraser. You're going to select the photo you want to edit and click on Edit Photo. And then you have your Magic Edit and Magic Eraser. So let's start with Magic Edit. You would click on Magic Edit. What the tool then asks you to do is, what do you want to replace? So you're going to highlight what you want to replace on the picture and add the words of whatever you want to add, and then it replaces it. So let's do it. I'm going to increase the brush size. Pretty nifty, right? These are my green apples. Some of the images don't look right at all. I love this one, and that's how you use your Magic Edit. So let's jump right back in on our next one, which is the Magic Eraser. You're gonna pick a picture and pick an object and erase it. So you're gonna select the Magic Eraser and you're gonna brush over the image that you want the software to take off. That's it. That Canva has unleashed on us is creating animation. So I've created this quick scene. What you then do, you pick an element and you add an animation so that you have an animation. So cool. I've created this little element and I'm going to then select create an animation. What you then need to do is to hold the shift while you're dragging your animation so that it creates straight lines. If you're using a Mac, use your arrow up. So I'm gonna click the element and you drag using the way that you want your element to move. And the aeroplane is in turbulence. You can then make it smooth. You can also make it steady. And you can make the speed that you want your element to be. This is pretty cool. I am so chuffed. Anyway, that's how you create your own animations. We'll do more videos like this if you let me know in the comments below. If this is adding value, also please smash the like button. Is BeatSync. You can edit your audio and add your audio, so you don't need to spend a lot of time trying to make sure that your videos align with your content and your music. BeatSync will align your music to your video. So we're going to look at an example that Canva has for us here. It is like seamless. You click on BeatSync, you sync it now, and then the music is synced below and it is seamless.
You call me a saint, but you know I'm a stranger, willing and able to do what you want. You think I'm a thing.
And you can do this with multiple audios that you've added yourself on uploads. And have fun with BeatSync. Our next gift is Brand Hub. Canva has upgraded the Brand Kit to Brand Hub. So when we explore the Brand Hub, it allows the whole team to work cohesively with logos and colors, and it centralizes all of our assets into one place. No more guesswork, and all of our icons, our imagery, our graphics are now under the Brand Hub. And we add our guidelines, and people don't read PDFs anyway. The guidelines are all under the hub for everyone new who joins, and there's no gray area of what it is that we need to follow with our CI. This also allows us to magically replace logos and images across existing designs in just few clicks. Brand Hub is amazing. The cool things that Canva has implemented inside our design area. With our settings, when you go on file and you go to view settings, Canva has added guidelines that you could use and tweak for your designs. There's a 3x3 grid, there's 6-column grid, there's 12-column grid. I love the 6-column grid because we could use this for our Instagram seamless posts that you would like to create. You could also customize it to exactly what you want. That is pretty cool. The other thing that Canva has included now are gradients. So if you choose a color and you scroll down, there's a new gradient section that's available. And it's not only to change the canvas to the color gradient that you want, it is also available if you want to change a gradient on a shape. So let's quickly do that. Let's add a square, and then we choose the color and we go to gradient, and we can make our gradient whatever color we want. I think that is pretty cool, and we're going to be creating amazing logos using this. One of the coolest thing Canva has introduced is layers. So we've always wanted layers. How does it work? When you've selected a design, you're going to go to your position and you're going to see all of the layers of the design that you're busy with. And you can hold and overlap them, and you can move your layers around. Layers are pretty cool. Bonus reminders of the AI tools that have been on Canva for a while is the resizing. So if you have an Instagram post and you want to resize, don't forget, the AI has made it so much easier for us to resize to whatever size we want and copy and make a duplicate of that. The other not so old one, it's the bulk create. It works very well with social media posts, TikToks that you want to create in bulk, Instagram. It works really well as quotes. So if you click on bulk create, you can enter the data manually or upload a CSV and create multiple posts instantly. I have created a video of this. You can also watch it. So all of these videos I've been referring to, I'm gonna add them on the description below. If you have enjoyed this content, be aware that we do have a membership on YouTube. Consider joining and becoming a member of our community, and we can design together. Thank you so much for joining me. I really enjoyed this. I will see you on the next video.